It's bad enough to lose a bag, but when you see the case of your vintage guitar shredded at the luggage pickup...
I let out a couple amazingly creative expletives.
Dave Schneider didn't want to check his baby. A Red Gibson ES-335 from 1965.
I begged, you know, I tried, I told them the value.
A little under $10,000, Dave says, but Delta agents in Buffalo insisted he couldn't carry it on, as he had always done before. When Dave landed in Detroit, he took out his phone and shot the guitar being transferred.
Can you possibly ask them to be careful with the guitars, if that's possible?
Sure, thank you.
A friendly flight crew member even went onto the tarmac, asking the baggage handlers to be gentle. But as Dave waited with the other passengers...
This big tier, three-tiered metal crate goes up an elevator shaft, and all of a sudden it just sounded like a wood shredder.
Actually, the case looked way worse than the guitar. It took employees an hour to extricate the instrument, which cost almost $2,000 to fix, and Dave says will never be the same. He did not do what another Dave, Dave Carroll, did 3.5 years ago.
You broke my Taylor guitar.
This Dave got fed up with getting the runaround from United after his guitar was damaged, so he wrote a song and performed it on YouTube.
'Cause United breaks guitars.
He even ended up writing a book, United Breaks Guitars, The Power of One Voice in the Age of Social Media. Well, now there's another voice, and Delta is responding. This is not representative of the great care we take with our customers' property. We have apologized and are working directly with the customer to rectify what happened.
I'm going to ask for $10,000. That's for the value of the guitar and for you shouldn't give people the runaround.
From an airline's PR point of view, guitars are a pain in the neck. Jeannie Mo, CNN. New York.